Welcome to Weld.com. So I've been reading all the comments, and everybody's been asking where Bob is. Well, here he is, Bob from Frankenfab, and he's going to show us some hard facing today. So welcome to Weld.com today. We have Bob from Frankenfab that's going to explain and walk us through the whole process of doing this hard facing.
Today we are going to prep some plate here, which would be like a wear plate that we put on, say, like an excavator bucket or densifier heads or even inside crusher walls. We're going to grind all the mill scale off. We're going to draw out some lines for our hard facing rod. We're going to preheat it, get it up to about 400 degrees, check it with our temp stick, and then we're going to get to laying down some beads. All right, so we're going to prep these plates. We're going to remove all this mill scale with the flap disc. We're going to draw out some lines, get our markings for what we're going to weld out. We're going to preheat it, and then we're going to lay down some beads. And then we're also going to do another section where we're going to do a surface buildup, which is like a buttering layer. And then we're going to run some more welding process, hard facing over that, so that you get a little better idea of what we're doing. Standard buildup versus buttering layer buildup, and then hopefully you guys will have a better idea of what hard facing is.
Man, check out these new Como hats they give us.
Look at this thing, man.
I like Como because they're durable and they've been around for a long time, so like their engineering is really top notch, and I know their fit's great.
Yeah, I like it, man. I really dig it. I like six panel. I like the stitch work.
Oh, yeah.
I like the flap. It's down low enough, it gets on your neck. It's high enough, it stays up. I like the fact that you can get them at like any
welding
supply shop in town. So
they're worldwide.
Definitely a killer cap. Great price too. All right, before we get started on the equipment, we first want to make sure that we got our power turned off. And then also inside of most of your boxes, inside of your information boxes, there's going to be some sort of power shutoff. We disconnected the antenna, which was a protocol for this machine. And any machine that you're not sure of, there should be some kind of guidebook to let you know what you should do for your safety procedures or lockouts, safety pins, any of those sort of situations. All right, we're inside this crusher cavity here, and we're going to focus on these wear plates here. We're going to do some hard facing on these. These ones have already been done, so we are going to prep these ones, clean all this trash and concrete out of here, and sand these down, get them a nice shine to them, draw out some lines on them, do some preheating, and then we're going to get to hard facing these plates. These plates are designed for when the rocks come in, they get pulverized under this rotor here, and then they take a beating onto this back wall, and this back wall is to help prevent, you know, wear and tear from the rest of the machine. So we are going to add some hard facing to these wear plates to extend the life of the wear plates, because they are not cheap, and us hard facing them will get them an extra use. So that's where we're going to start. All right, so we're just drawing out a little simple line pattern here. It's just to kind of keep us uniform, and it really helps just with the wear. We could run them different pattern. A lot of times we do checkerboard pattern, or sometimes we'll do just random patterns. But for this machinery, it keeps it real simple just to run standard lines out, and it helps prevent, you know, keeps the wear up, and that's how we're doing. All right, so we're getting prepped. We're ready to go. We're gonna do some preheating with the torch over here. And then we're going to use the Alpha TIG, the new Alpha TIG 225XI, to run our hard facing passes. So we're going to get this thing fired up, and then we'll get ready. We're going to start running the torch, and then almost right after that, we're going to start laying down some beads while our plate's still hot. I think we're going to run about 120 amps. We're going to be using this post alloy tubular hard facing rods, pretty slick. We also got some Studi 35 rods. We're going to try and run some passes on those too, to give you guys a little description, a different idea of how the different rods burn. And then we'll check it out when we're done.
Thank you.
All right, so you see we just got these rods laid out. I got a checkerboard pattern in here. It's similar to what we normally do in the field. What we're gonna do over here is we're gonna simulate a piece of equipment that was worn down and is in need of buildup and also hard facing. So we're gonna run some Bowler Fox EV50s, 7018 rod to run a base layer. And then we're gonna clean that and stack some new hard facing rod right over the top of that. And let's check it out. All right, welcome back. We just got done running this Bowler Fox EV50 7018 rods as our buildup or our buttering layer. We do this in certain situations where, say, like the equipment is worn down and it has a dramatic wear to it. We do this 7018 buildup to bring back to life what was there, and then we'll lay our hard facing rod right over the top of that. In some situations with different kinds of shears or different kinds of pieces of equipment, you're not supposed to put the hard facing rod directly onto the parent material. So in some situations we do run a 7018 rod as a base and then we'll run the hard facing over that. In this situation, we are bringing back what was worn out. So now we're just gonna clean it up a little bit and then run some hard facing rod over that and we'll see how it turns out. Now this is all ground down. We're gonna lay some hard facing rods right over the top. All right, we just got done laying down these hard facing rods over the top of our 7018 buttered layer. You can definitely see how it turned out a little bit better. Beads wise and golden arm look, again, doesn't really matter as long as these rods, as long as this bead is doing its job in preventing wear and tear on our main equipment. All right, so if you like what you see here, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and we got a bunch more things coming up for you in the future. Keep your eyes peeled and check you out on the next one.